Thank you all for joining us today. The Women in Machine Learning Symposium is an inclusive event for people to advance in machine learning and find a community of practitioners in the field. Regardless of your experience or expertise level, there's a path for you at this event and afterwards.
Google's unique in that we provide end-to-end building blocks across the ML lifecycle that let anyone with any level of expertise build amazing innovation in ML, whether you're taking your first steps as a learner or building massive language models. This includes everything across our tensor projects, from dealing with data, defining models across a variety of growing frameworks like TensorFlow, Keras, and JAX, training models, deploying them to various surfaces, including mobile, IoT, and microcontrollers, and web ML, and managing and operating systems that use them. And all of this is underpinned by accelerated infrastructure for training and inference, as well as the tools that help you to be responsible across the board. We have ML offerings for everyone.
MediaPipe Studio. This is particularly exciting for developers who want to use ML in their apps or sites, but don't necessarily have that expertise in ML. The goal is to give you an easy way to create advanced ML solutions with easy-to-use, low-code, and no-code tooling. We're also excited to announce our first mobile competition on Kaggle, where we will focus on AI and ML helping the parents of deaf children learn how to use sign language. I'm excited to announce the launch of our new developer site for recommenders on TensorFlow.org. It's a one-stop shop for everything you need to understand how to use ML to build recommender systems, and it will get you up and running with TensorFlow recommenders and guide you when you need to go that little bit deeper to do things like optimizing with complementary APIs such as TensorFlow Ranking or Google Scan. So check it out at this URL.
So what we want to do is predict the values in columns with empty cells. In this case, like I mentioned earlier, I want to know if the AI can correctly predict the species of penguin. Next, what we want to do is pick the columns that we will use to train our ML model. Each of these columns represents a variable, like bill length or which island they were found. So let's pick them all. And finally, I'm going to click predict. And after a few seconds, voila. You can see the model predicted the species of all penguins that were missing in the dataset, and with high confidence scores too. Just look at how easy and fun it can be to use ML.
When we think about machine learning, it's the same question. How do the decisions that we make at each step of the process affect the end outcome for a user? Because unfairness can enter into the system at any point in the pipeline, whether that is data collection and handling, and where we're collecting the data from, who is collecting the data, how is that data being collected, to how we label that data, to training using specific objectives, and whether or not our objectives are appropriate for the majority and the minority, to how the users experience the data and the effect that they see. And then that, of course, goes back and filters into the data that we're collecting.
So I'll talk a little bit about the diffusion process. We're starting by taking an input image and we'll refer it to X sub zero. And then we're adding noise to it over a certain amount of steps, or in this case, capital T steps. And this process is known as the forward process or diffusion. And there's a neural network that will try to recover the original input image after all of that noise has been added. And that part is known as reverse diffusion or denoising. We start off with this first picture of Golden Gate Bridge, and that is X sub zero. It's completely clear. There's no noise right there. And then at every step, we're kind of injecting this noise, and you can see it getting blurrier and blurrier until at X sub capital T, it is complete noise. And for notation purposes, I'll mention that the distribution Q represents the real data distribution.
We have the chance to plant trees when we do this work. When we take this tool, simultaneously the most overhyped and yet also underappreciated tool of the modern world, machine learning. And we can go out and plant trees and help other people, even if it doesn't directly benefit us. So that's what I'm asking all of you to do today. I want all of you to take everything you've learned from this entire conference, every vision you've had, every moment that sparked something in you, something amazing, I want you to take that tonight. Don't wait. And I want you to go out and plant a tree. And someday, people will rest under its shade.